Gentlemen, welcome back. Tonight we are going live with the fourth episode, Dark Room, of Life is Strange, that just happened to come out today, which is fantastic. Sort of played into our week-long playthrough of this game up to date absolutely perfectly. Here we go. Let's see how we go with this.
Previously on Life is Strange. Whoa.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Don't ever touch me again.
This is a lot of stuff from the last couple episodes, which is great to go see. Loved the diner scene here. Was fantastic. Let's, especially the way that you played in with the superpowers.
What are you doing here, Matt?
Essentially.
Stop.
It was great.
Don't come near me.
Not now. It won't work.
I know.
Oh, no.
This isn't pleasant.
And this is when we
please
accuse the rich boy of Stanley what he's done.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing
And of course, this was chosen by you guys to,
to
shoot
Rachel
at him.
Soon.
Obviously, the gun had
like
no bullets.
Said, it's time to start the search for clues. Welcome to my domain.
Let's see what we've got
Let's
here.
Find what we want
and we go around and snoop. There was money in that drawer, if you don't remember. And we managed to leave the money, which was great.
That's it.
Absolutely fantastic.
Listen, I found pictures.
And we got into Frank's trailer. And yeah, it was great.
I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
No, you don't.
You know what it's
and of
like
course, this was the crazy, crazy thing.
Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
And the repercussions of
Hello?
Doing so
are you even listening, Maxine?
Were
this is totally
nuts.
Fucked up.
Absolutely
what else
nuts.
Have I changed?
Max Caulfield. Hold on.
Here we go.
Chloe.
And this
you
is.
You have a visitor.
An absolute shocking moment when you realize the thing you did was save her dad actually crippled Chloe. Let's see what this episode's got for us. Really hope we figure out what is going on in regards to... Well, a lot of things have changed then, I guess. It's the end of the world party, I think, is one of the ones that's happening now. One of the events that's happening in this game. Okay, so we're starting on the beach. Watch out, Mr. Crab. No, you're right, bro. Damn, some of this stuff is just gorgeous. If you see me screenshotting, it's just because of this game. The scenery that it depicts is just absolutely unbelievable, right? Like... Yeah, it's great. Hella dank blooms in this. Hella dank blooms. Mr. Toppid. Damn. So since we went back and changed the past, which saved Chloe's dad but put her in a wheelchair, all of these whales seem to have beached themselves. Possibly still a sign that the cyclone's gonna come. Maybe, maybe not. But this is really, it's really disturbing seeing Chloe from being a little punk, basically,
it's
to being
weird hanging out with you
this.
Again. I know.
It's
I'm glad
crazy.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper. It's so Max. So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery. Probably easier to write than to visit me.
It's true.
I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much. Yeah.
The worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop? This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue.
Damn.
You could take some amazing shots. Those beached whales are so sad. I kind of know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
Oh, shit.
Are you okay to talk about the accident?
We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and that was the last thing I ever felt in my body. When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
Here we go.
What missing girl?
I don't know her name. I just read about it in the news. I feel bad for her family.
So still some things that she couldn't change.
Such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow and eclipse, it's more like the end of the world.
Don't say that.
I'm not trying to bum you out. It just seems like Arcadia Bay is having a meltdown.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong. You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word. No
offense. Oh, wow. She's completely different to the Chloe that we knew. No. The Chloe that was before is now gone, and now we have this more calmer version of Chloe. Which is strange. Completely strange. Certainly know how to set up a decent frame in this. Once again, that lighthouse is sitting there. Alrighty. So now, Chloe's mum didn't have to. Well, Chloe's dad didn't die. She's moved into the
feels like a high-tech cell.
That used to be the storeroom, I guess.
My parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you are here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, I know.
Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive, when you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch me take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science doll.
I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids.
Thanks again for coming, Max. I need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water?
Let's have a look around.
I still can't believe I put Chloe in that chair.
It's not cool. It's definitely not cool. Man, the guilt must have been huge.
It's nice my parents sent a card at least. I wonder who this is. Kind of a generic card.
Megan! Wait, say Megan?
I wasn't very available to Chloe.
They're dropping quick. No, they know I'm thinking of you. Super so lame, writing shit like hope you're well, etc. And your life is different now, and I don't want that to get in the way of our friendship. Yes, I haven't been around lately, but that will change soon.
At least hope I sent well. Road trip selfies to Chloe. I'm sure that made her feel great.
Absolutely. Guilting the crap out of her.
Man, Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe.
That's crazy.
They're so great. Chloe is still a punk at heart. But she can't stage dive anymore. That's so cool that Chloe has made friends online.
Hot Wheels chat room. So what are you doing talking to you? Ha, no shit. I'm about binge on Quantum Leap. Oh my god. Michael Rules, so do you. If you don't want to say hey, I have to take care of some body work. Get back to while you're binging on Beluga. You better. Hello.
Whoa, Chloe can totally control her computer.
That's crazy.
It's so great people get this high-tech help. I should offer to put makeup on for Chloe. Not that I can, but it would be fun. There's the old Chloe. Drink up, Buttercup.
Oh, man.
No wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year.
Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring.
Ouch. It was just a thought.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine.
You sound like an adult.
Oh, man.
It seems like we were kids in another life.
What do you remember about us as kids? We all have different memories.
I think about us as little pirates running and jumping through Arcadia Bay.
Me too. But we're still pirates in our own way.
Yeah, right. Check me out, Chloe of the Caribbean. No way will I get on a fucking boat now. Unless you're with me. As you can see, I can't keep all my other friends away.
You have me. I'm not leaving you, Chloe.
Well, you didn't visit me a lot either. I mean, I loved your cards and photos, but
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
Are they okay? I mean, are they still happy together and everything?
So now you're Dr. Bill? I guess they're good, considering they have to deal with me. They laugh and hold hands. And I hope they still get busy, too.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them.
Man.
Our insurance sucks, and the medical bills are fucking insane.
Can they pay all the bills?
No way. They keep the numbers away from me, but it doesn't take much research to find out I'm costing my parents almost $1 million.
Holy shit.
Chloe, you're priceless. Unintended.
You're such a geek. That's why I love you. Of course, I know a geek when I be one. See, I'm practically a human entertainment system. It would be sweet to chill out together and watch a movie like when you'd spend the night at my house.
Yeah, man.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in like a mellow Blade Runner mood. I always cry at the end. Plus, you know, I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Pris.
I know. You would look incredible with blue hair. Now let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when we watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
Damn.
Thanks. I think you missed a grain stuck in my eyeball.
Hard to believe how just a little sand can cause such a big mess.
Oh,
it's
man.
Like that Chinese proverb, a spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. You know, like the butterfly thing.
So I've heard. She has to use a lot of lotion to keep her blood circulating.
That sucks, man.
Nothing but medical supplies. Oh man, she has to use that ventilator just to breathe. At least Chloe doesn't weigh that much. Wowzer. Chloe was a straight A student.
Damn.
She could have gone to any college. What a bastard. I totally should have let Chloe steal your bullshit fund, even if it wasn't another reality.
Damn it.
Despite everything, they're still a happy family again. It's cool that in this reality, Chloe really loves skating too.
That's at least a constant for her. Let's have a look.
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood?
Man.
She can't even feel the grass now. That's a serious heat lamp. Hello, Chloe. She likes fluffy animals now. So here's the DVD player. Now I just need to find the DVD. Oh, the snow dough. I guess not everything changed. Snow globes are taking over. Here's the DVD.
I want to look in this other drawer as well.
Oh my god. I made that mix for her when we were 12.
Man. Oh, so jarring. From the Chloe knew. Man, it sucks. Sucks that we did that to her. Right. Bathroom, I guess, mask optional. Man, you gotta think. I guess this storyline was always moving towards this, but.
I can't believe you fell asleep so fast. How dare you?
I know you were beat down after the day with me, and Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
Damn.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates, jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit. I'm getting my regular head pains. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep the swag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe. They gave Chloe their giant expensive HDTV, and they use her shitty tube television.
Nice and cool, so make sure it was F5. Oh man. Again. So she's like friends with all of the bad and all the people that were like crap to her before.
Damn.
Oh, shit.
This is just for Chloe's basic supplies.
8,000.
Bonjour. That's great they finally went to Paris. To think that our destiny is linked to goddamn keys.
Yeah, man.
Keys.
God damn.
Yep, that's the same graffiti from before. They might get their own home taken away because of medical bills.
Shit.
That's terrible.
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You
That's
look
crazy.
Exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
Paris trip.
So you finally made it to Paris.
Oui, as they say. Not me, because I can't speak French. But it was a great experience.
That's great.
Especially for Chloe.
I can see her loving it there. You guys rock for going on a family adventure like that.
She talked about going to school there. But that's not practical anymore. It's not fair, Max.
I don't know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
Is she mad at me for not staying in touch? She should be. I have no excuse.
She was disappointed, but she knows you care. And I know how hard it is to process all this. It's taken us years.
William, I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
Joyce.
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So, it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
Hey, Starcaller. Welcome back, man. Start with the weather.
What do you think is going on with all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe and Joyce. My family.
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber.
Oh, yes. She went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question?
Sounds like you know them well.
More than I want to. Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates.
Oh, wow.
I don't even like to think about it.
She isn't working at Two Bells anymore. Care room.
Oh, I was impressed by Chloe's room. All the high-tech equipment.
Yeah.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. Insurance helps, but... I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys, financially.
His bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. Price is always right. Get it? No?
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
No change to spare anymore.
Damn.
Back to cookies.
Oh, they're doing the cookie one
thing.
Choice
is a food coupon, boss.
There isn't anything.
Just shoot me now.
Man, this sucks.
Joyce and William never had a garage sale before. They're drowning in debt. Just to take care of their daughter. Such bullshit.
She's written federal customer and informed me that health insurance no longer covers Chloe's rehab and the standard rate of $1,250 a week. That sucks, man. Really sucks. Heavy too, man. Far out. Is it up in here? Is it in the bathroom? Is that bird still here? Oh, maybe not.
It's cool that Chloe uses natural medicine too. Nothing here.
Oh, the cabinet. The cabinet.
Here it is. I never thought I'd be delivering morphine to my best friend. The bathroom looks almost the same. Just more medicine.
Jesus. Hey, Meryl.
How's it going, Time Tripper? Funny. I think I look older. It's all about you, Arcadia Bay, isn't it?
I wonder.
Oh, Max, it is so nice to have you around.
Oh no. I didn't realize how bad Chloe's injury really was.
Loss of breath as Dr. Owen needed a well-being, but I want you to understand that respiratory failure is common in people with severe spinal injuries. Your daughter is one of the bravest, strongest patients I've had, and I'm proud of working there to support your parents. Prepare for all, any and all possibility. Believe Chloe should be aware of her gender condition. We'll discuss further of contact information.
Joyce is already a super mom.
Dr. Bill. Nice parody on Dr. Phil.
Huh. Joyce used to hate smokers in the diner.
Good morning, Max. Oh, you and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
I remember. It's nice waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years. After the accident.
Man.
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together again.
He's been such a hero through all this. Chloe and I, lucky to have him.
Damn. William's still the same?
Is William still the same? After everything that's happened?
For better and for worse. But always for the better.
That's good.
I never thought I'd love a man so much I can't imagine life without him. It sounds corny, I know.
You rule, Joyce.
Shit. Things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
How are you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing the best I can, Max.
Sam.
Won't lie. It's difficult, but nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
Let's work.
Plus, you guys have to work, too.
Bill and I have no time for ourselves. We're working more than we're living. I even had to take a part-time gig at Pan Estates. Ugh.
Do you know the Prescotts?
I know that Sean Prescott won't be happy until he owns everything in Arcadia Bay.
Damn.
Stay away from his son, Nathan.
Yeah, man.
So, what do you think is going on here with all of this eco-havoc?
Maybe Arcadia Bay just wants to be left alone. I know the feeling. Honestly,
Sam,
I don't give a shit about too much outside our house.
I don't blame you, Joyce.
Except now we have dead birds and beach whales outside our front door. So maybe I should care, for Chloe's sake.
Do you know somebody named David Madsen? He, might hang out at the Two Whales.
Well, that was random. Yeah, he's a bus driver. He comes in sometimes. Cute, quiet. Why?
Oh, I was just curious.
You always were. Nice to see that everything.
Nice save, Chloe.
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max, you're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
I hope so. You guys do such an amazing job taking care of her.
We can only do so much, and she gets damn sick of her parents. That's why it's so important you came to spend time with her. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak.
Sucks.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Joyce. I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Bad or good, I embrace every moment with my daughter and my husband. This is what it means to be a family. And we'll always be one. No matter what.
I better get back to Chloe now. It's good talking with you, Joyce.
You too, honey. It's good for Chloe to stay in touch with her friends.
William is trying so hard. He's still awesome.
Dr. Bill's getting a lot of coverage in this game.
That is such a sweet shot of Chloe. I wonder who took the picture. Look at them. They have no idea what's in their future.
Damn. Let's have a look. These books are still being here. Let's have a look out
apparently
here.
The only thing that hasn't changed is this view.
Okay, can we go to this room? We can. Damn. It's so empty. The heck, man?
A blue butterfly? I'm sure this is a total coincidence.
I don't know.
At least we never had to hide from Step Douche. I guess we stopped growing up together. I'm still overwhelmed by this new reality.
It's not cool. It's definitely not cool.
I feel so guilty for putting Chloe and her family through this. I
could give Chloe the choice of keeping William alive, but that would be cruel. But then I see that they're a family again, and who am I to judge?
It's not cool at all.
I never heard much about William's brother.
Hi, Bill. Sorry for saying such a sincere accident. Works in Parliament. I'm being sent to Salt Lake City to have a new parking lot. If you have to go where the work is these days, wish I would send you a bigger check, but you know the story. Money's nobody's favorite thing. Maybe I'll see you next spring for a visit. Kiss Chloe, enjoy me. Hang in there, Billy. Yeah, brother, Aaron.
Shoes. Chloe always did love stomping around in her boots. Toys? I kind of want to open this and see what's in here. They bought crutches for Chloe, hoping she might walk again. Too bad Joyce.
This is heavy, man. This is a heavy episode. This is a really heavy episode. Thank you for keeping me updated on Chloe's condition. I can imagine the struggle you and William are going through. I'm so sorry that we can't help all alone at this time, like everybody else. I'm underwater with my own medical bills. Please give Chloe a hug and kiss. Best wish. Love, Aunt Dorothy. Spent a lot of time up here. Nope. Okay. Let's go back downstairs. Man. Look there. No, nothing. Food coupons, William.
I definitely have to take a third job.
Damn.
Finally. Give me the blue pill.
I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise.
Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless.
Okay, but get ready to yell for your folks if I screw up.
Oh, trust me. I will. Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high.
You're so adorable. Do you want anything else?
Stop me if I'm being too emo, but can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids.
Please. My diary is like emo ground zero. Plus, Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price.
Ever.
Ever.
Oh, man.
Is that okay?
This is really perfect. Heavy.
Oh my god, look how little we are there. We look like toys.
I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me.
Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
There's still time for you. Oh, man.
Life is strange.
I love that shot of us. It's hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago.
Literally seems like yesterday.
I wish it was.
Me too. This photo.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe I could.
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out.
Oh, no.
So, I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory.
Oh.
You understand?
Yes, I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11.
Oh. No. What do we do? What do we do? Do we accept? Do we refuse? I don't know. Have to refuse.
Can't. It wrecks me to see you in any pain, but I don't have any right to do this.
I'm an adult. I'm giving you the right.
But Joyce and William.
I already said my goodbyes to them, but they won't honor my wishes. You will. Right?
I can't kill you with an overdose.
Max, I'm dying from my illness, not my dosage. This accelerates the process. I'd rather go out on a wave than a rock. And I want my best friend to help me out.
I'm going to help you. I'm not like that.
Got it!
Frosty Shannon, thanks for following.
Got it!
Why, Max?
You're just feeling on me. It was weird how long it took her to reply.
Why don't you go now? You've been wanting to since you got here, right? So go and don't come back.
Chloe, I am never leaving you again.
What the hell, man? You can go back in time and change all this. No. Oh, I don't want to. Oh. We'll go the other option first. Man.
Chloe, I really don't know if I can do this. I had another friend who wanted to end it all. And I did everything I could to try and save her life. How can I be responsible for ending yours? I mean, there's gotta be another way.
Max, you were there for your friend, no matter what. Now I'm asking you to help me the same way.
I want to help you, Chloe, but I think my help is hurting.
At least you have a choice. When you want to make a decision, you can just do it. Look at me. I'm at the mercy of everybody.
For this once, is crazy. This is super heavy, man. Super heavy.
The most important one of my life. Please. Help me, Max.
Can't.
You gotta be kidding me that there's no other option. You've gotta be kidding me that there is no other option at all. Fuck. Okay. This is messed up. This is completely messed up. You know, like. How?
Should I rewind or stop? I definitely can't stop here. I'm sorry, William.
See you soon, Frosty.
Someday Dad will get one of the newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper.
But you can. You can just tell her not to get the car.
What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course, I'll come pick you up. Shit, where are my keys? Aha! You can't hide from me forever. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting.
She can't go back in time.
Don't blow it, because world famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like, you're never gonna see us again.
Chloe, I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
Damn. So we had the chance to. We had the chance to change the past.
You have made things different. Like, my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong. Even if you feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back. Always.
That's all been reverted. Yeah, that sucks. Oh, Step Douche is back in the picture. Okay. 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 So everything's switched back. Everything's back. Man.
Chloe, you're back.
Whoa, down, Max. You get one kiss, now you're all over me?
I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together.
Minaria.
Max, did you forget we've gone over this? I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
Not anymore. I'm just spaced out too.
Damn.
Welcome back to the real world, Max. Let's look at the big board and see all our pieces in the puzzle so far. That snow dough always makes me think of William and Chloe.
Right.
So close, yet so far away. We have to do three main things.
Right. What things?
One, decipher Frank's logbook.
Yep.
Two, get Nathan's phone to find out where he's been during the Vortex Club parties with Kate and Rachel. And see whatever hidden shit he's got in his messages.
It's true.
Three, beat Step Douche Dan until he tells us about Frank, Nathan, and the Dark Room. And I do have a gun.
It's a pretty good idea. Oh, yeah.
Keep it in your pants. We'll have to do this on our own.
Dude, at least let me kick his ass, then rewind. Fine, whatevs. It's your power.
Which I can't waste on shit like that. Or Blackwell would be in big trouble.
You didn't even let me take that money to pay Frank off.
And I'm glad. We have to be better than that.
I know. You should get busy in the garage to see what dirt you can dig up. I'm gonna cyberstalk some names and see where that leads.
Cool.
To who.
Cool.
And be careful of Stepcrack. He's not gonna be a happy camper after you reamed him yesterday and Mom is giving him the boot.
I'm on it, partner. I can't abuse this level. I'm so sorry, William. It's not fair you had to die twice. Yes, Chloe Price was here. Staying up all night is the best excuse to drink lots of coffee. Even Holmes and Watson didn't use every piece of information. This is a serious exposé on the Prescotts. Finally. That's my Chloe. This butterfly photo seems like a million years ago. How much time have I altered since?
Crazy.
Oh no.
Oh, the little bird.
That poor little bird has been trapped in here.
Let's chase him out. Where are you, little bird?
That blue dye makes me so happy. It means the real Chloe is back with me.
Fly, what's up, buddy?
Be free.
cool. So that little bird's gonna have big impact, eh? We'll see what pans out.
You won this battle, Max. You broke up my family. I salute you.
David, I didn't try to hurt you. Ever. But I won't let anybody hurt Chloe.
Too late, isn't it? You just better be damn careful with her. Don't you wander off into the dark.
Yep.
David isn't any different from me when he's looking at those family photos. Those poor whales are like beached angels. What is going on here?
Yeah, Max, frankly, it takes... Wait, no. She sounds hot, so I get whack. Let's test no. I'm sorry, it's supposed to be funny to say. I'm just being dad and some stuff like you. I will kill you guys later. I love you. So, Courtney, hey, girl, for me, you know when you want to come by, I'm really good. Thanks, Courtney. I'm sometime about to check you later. Cool, so we'll go see her later. Do you know Frank? Sorry from his bag, adjusting your busy works, Max. Busy blazing, what up? Do you know Frank Bowers? Drugs, that's it. Ask Nathan, he knows him, I think. For what? Okay, Juliet. Why do you an investigation with my helmet on board? Thank you, I can give secrets from Rich. Reporter Juliet Watson, hello. Make sure the head's going on, but they're up there. They're doing military tests, something. You're right in the eye of the storm. No communicate, at least you're alive through this war, so save as long as round. So. Now back to looks. Talk soon. Kate.
Ouch.
David, don't be when I get back from work. I mean it.
Looks like they're back on the road to Paris.
Look.
To think this all started with my vision of a tornado. My butterfly sketch doesn't exist in this timeline. Like,
oh man, that sucks.
Max the Time Bandit strikes again.
It's more dead birds. What the heck?
Poor birds. I guess David wasn't in the mood to clean up.
That's not cool, man. Tell us that.
William never finished painting that wall.
Damn, man. Okay. So we need to go start snooping around. Oh, shit.
Joyce must be so upset. Are you helping anybody, Max?
He's cleaned it all out.
Looks like David finished his car repairs. Maybe there's some new clues around.
Maybe. Let's have a look. Look at this.
Should I have signed the petition? Blackwell sure isn't safe and private anymore. Oh, meow, Miss Grant. Twist that knife. At least he has one weird fan.
Having scorched me.
Wish I had surveillance footage of that conversation.
Based on the clips of the legends, might as well carry without me or continue to spread.
Surveillance cameras at Pan Estates? David must be working for the Prescotts too.
What the heck? Alright. Let's see what we've got here. Ooh. What is that?
There's more to David Madsen than meets the eye. He should finish this letter to Joyce.
Yeah, I'm gonna explain myself since I know that nobody's ever understood me the way you do. You'd never do anything to hurt you or Chloe's taking my family's number one mission. Yes, I overstepped my bounds with surveillance and suspicion. And I'm truly sorry and ashamed, but there are dark things happening at Arcadia Bay. I've never told you. You're my wife and partner, and I know you should have no secrets. I intended to tell you everything, but I wanted more proof. Instead, a student almost committed suicide on my watch. You kicked him out of my favorite home, and my stepdaughter hates me. Please let me. Damn, man. William Stuff.
Oh, that makes me sad. It was so incredible to see William again. I wish Chloe could, too.
So what's in here?
Oh, jeez. David is packing up wedding stuff, too. Either Chloe stole another gun, or David is out there armed. What the hell did David do for Nathan? And what did his dad do for David?
Interesting. Let's have a look at... Whew, what's going on here? There's got to be something in here. There's got to be something that we can use. Locker.
Whoa, that is a serious padlock on that locker. Hey, David, what you hiding? For once, I don't have time to search for the code. Oh, I need to find a way to break this padlock.
We should... Ladder, maybe? Is there a pole? No. Is there an axe? Is there an axe or something we can use? Hey! What's this?
I wonder if David is going to the party.
Where is... Crowbar. Awesome.
Okay. I can use that crowbar to pry open the locker.
Crowbar.
Sorry, David, but I bet you would do the same thing as me. Notes, coordinates, photos of Kate, Nathan. Oh, yes.
Okay, cool. We got some info. What else we got?
Score. Back to Chloe now.
Okay.
Yo, Chloe! Are you ready yet? I have to get back to my dorm.
Are we happy?
Very happy. I hit the secret file jackpot. Kate, Nathan, and Rachel. Plus some location coordinates. David is like a one-man surveillance army. Now let's get the hell out of here before we get busted.
Damn.
But okay. I absolutely have to go see Kate in the hospital right now. I want to find out how she's doing.
Off to the hospital we go. with a bit of video. Doesn't look like it's pre-rendered. This is going to be interesting. We're in the hospital. We are in the hospital.
This is definitely Kate's floor.
The hospitals always freak me out.
I hear you. But imagine how Kate feels. I'm so glad I get to see her again. I hope it's not too weird for her.
No, she'll be stoked to see you. Who wouldn't be?
This be it. I'm a little nervous.
Just go in there and be your friend. I'll wait out here so you can chill by yourselves. I was a total dick for blowing a fuse when you answered Kate's call the other day. Good thing you ignored me.
Guilty! Guilty, guilty, guilty!
I had no idea what shit she was going through. And you saved her. Like me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you will be. You will be. You will be.
Thanks, Chloe. But don't be sorry. We're all on the same team.
Team Max. Let Kate know we're gonna string Nathan up by his balls then.
Oh, yes. I'm on it.
All right. What do you got to waste? Is she gonna be in there? Oh, she's in there. Cool.
Max!
Oh, Kate.
I thought I'd never see you again. I feel so ridiculous. I'm so sorry.
Kate, listen to me. You have nothing to be sorry about.
Other people do. It's true. It's so true.
You do not know how happy I am to see you. You look awesome. Is it a stupid question if I ask how you're doing?
Now that you're here, I'm doing even better. I'm so grateful to you for coming up to the roof to talk me down. Max, I felt so lost and alone.
Man.
When I saw how much you cared, how hard you were trying, you made me realize I wasn't alone. Thank you.
Kate, there are so many people who love you and want to help you.
I know. You should see all the letters and postcards. I gave most of the flowers to other patients here because they need them more than me. I'm keeping the balloons, though. One of the nurses gave me some pen and paper so I could do some drawings.
Oh, that's good.
I love your illustrations.
They got kind of dark there for a while. But I have an idea for a new children's book about bullying. I was thinking of having some photographs in there, too.
I hope that's a subtle hint that you'll let me take the photographs for the book.
Was that subtle? You better take the pictures, Max. I'm going to be here for another day until my family comes out to visit.
How are they treating you?
Like they need to protect me forever. They're so upset, and I know they feel guilty even though they didn't do anything.
Sure.
I was surprised how many students from Blackwell wrote me. Daniel, Mr. Jefferson.
Miss Jefferson?
Even Victoria wrote me a very sweet note. And I believe she was being
worried. It's not in the background. Oh, it's a painting from before. A picture from before.
Kate. I'm working on it, Max.
She got like
I just pray Mothman prophecy right.
Had a shirt on. Okay, so let's have a look. Flowers.
Those are nice flowers. And from Taylor? Wow, props to her.
Guilty flowers.
If this gets Kate through the night, so be it. I don't think get well is quite apropos.
Look.
That is so sweet. Even Victoria signed. But not Nathan.
Yeah, that's right. Mofo.
Victoria Chase might be queen bitch, but she's not evil. Principal Wells knows how to step it up when he wants to.
Intelligence was really in honor. Community support for any student in our history. My words may mean little given your circumstances, but it's important to know we do care. If you need assistance at all, please let us know to ask. Cool.
Thank you, sisters. You really saved Kate.
Right, let's see what Kate has. What's all these drawings?
Oh, I love Kate's happy rainbow
frog. I miss my banana.
Good to see that Kate is still working on her book report.
Kate, it is so good to hang out with you again.
Let's see what we got.
I owe you so much. And I can tell you want to talk to me about something.
Victoria.
I saw Victoria's letter. How does that make you feel?
Max, I know Victoria can be not nice, but I do believe in forgiveness and redemption.
Okay.
I might be naive, but
okay.
I feel her struggle.
Me too. I could have taken a picture of her covered in paint, but I didn't, and we had a genuine moment.
We all have our moments. Why do you think she acts so mean?
She's insecure. If you're comfortable with yourself, you don't need to act superior.
Victoria doesn't look like she has much to be insecure about.
If anybody could make Victoria see the light, it would be Kate Marsh.
Boom! Dropping truth bombs.
More than that, Max.
I always want to talk to you.
We missed our tea session this week.
That was so not cool. We need to plan, like, a tea shop tour of Portland.
Oh, yes. And you could bring Warren along, too.
What do you think of Warren?
Oh, smart and silly. He's got such a good heart. And he's a cutie pie.
Oh my god, it's a cutie pie.
You know he likes you. And I'm going to the drive-in with him, so we'll see. With everything that's going on, a date seems weird.
No. You deserve that.
Kate Marsh, matchmaker. I'm glad somebody is looking out for my love life.
Even angels need angels, Max.
Nathan.
I want you to know I'm this close to getting all the info I need about Nathan.
Nathan Prescott has to pay for what he did.
He does.
We have to stop him from hurting anybody else.
Oh,
well,
yeah.
I did get his ass suspended, so that might be a start.
You did? Oh, right on, Max. I love how fearless you are. So what is going on with him now?
What's his call?
I assume he'll show up at the Vortex Club party tonight like nothing happened.
Yeah.
And nobody can do anything to him after what he did.
We're going to stop him. I just have to find Nathan's room number, get inside, and get the clues I need.
Max, please let me help. I can get the number, and I'll text it to you, okay?
Of course, Kate. I can't do this without you.
Now it's time for Nathan to watch out for us.
I have to get back to our mission. You don't know how much it means to see you again.
I do. That's why I love you, Max. Thanks for taking care of my bunny. Tell Alice I'll see her soon. Thanks again for visiting me, Max.
Cool.
Well, how is she?
She's still Kate Marsh. Thank God.
I'm glad we came to see her.
Thanks for coming with me.
Now let's go pay a visit to Nathan Prescott. That little prick is not going to be glad when he sees
us.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, yeah. Still doing those tray flips. Creepy old janitor. So you have to run around and have a chat to everyone, I think.
Hey, Max. How you doing?
Oh, hi, Mr. Jefferson.
Hey, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm okay. And this is my friend Chloe.
Yo.
Chloe? Why isn't somebody as cool as you going to Blackwell?
I was way too cool for this school. It's a long story. In actual files here.
I can imagine. Max, are you sure that you're all right?
It's weird just being on campus like everything's normal.
I know. Lame as it sounds, life has to go on.
I think there's too much going on in my life.
On that note, Blackwell duty calls. Remember, I'm going to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes contest tonight at the party. So I hope you'll be there to celebrate, even though I'm sorry you didn't enter a photo. I understand your reasons. You can't force an artist to work.
I feel like a total loser, but it's been a hard week to focus. No pun intended.
I'm proud of you for caring so much about a troubled friend. And I take hope in the fact that you have plenty of time to find your way. Just get in the habit of putting your work out there.
Thanks, Mr. Jefferson. I'll definitely be there tonight.
Me too. I'll be Max's date. You better dance with us at least once.
Nobody should have to see me dance. Plus, you don't want to watch the old hipster trying to keep up with the kids. I have some pride. Be seeing you.
Yes, I will.
Hipster.
Hot for teacher.
Rose! You are out of control.
Not yet. Just wait until the rager tonight.
Shut up.
Don't be jealous because Mark Jefferson thinks I'm cool.
I am so ignoring you.
Fine. Since I'm here, I'll see if I can get some dirt from Justin. I haven't talked to him in a while.
Now that is a great plan.
All right.
Let's see if I can find out where Nathan is.
Hey, skater dude.
Hey, skater dude.
Nope.
Justin, it's been so long since I've seen you.
Hey, Daniel.
Hey, Daniel. You look bummed out. Are you alright?
Hola, Max. I just figured out that my photos basically suck. I'm a wannabe artist.
Fedora.
You're not here to be a photographer. That's my gig. Look at that sketch you did of me. Incredible. Okay, and that's your art. Your gift.
I do feel better now. You are good, Max.
Have you talked to anybody about what happened with Kate?
I don't talk to anyone, Max. But I did actually have a nice talk with Brooke.
Ooh.
She couldn't stop talking about how brave you were on that roof.
I don't think doing the right thing is brave, but I appreciate what she means. The most important thing is that Kate gets better and gets justice.
It's true.
I hear that, Max. She's the sweetest, most genuine person I've ever met. I don't mind getting picked on by Blackwell Brohold, but don't fuck with Kate.
I like this revolutionary Daniel Da Costa.
Only if I can start the revolution from my sketchbook, Max.
By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott?
Oh, I heard a rumor he's actually suspended.
Yeah, but he's still gotta be on campus.
That explains why he looked so pissed off when I saw him leaving campus a few moments ago.
Are you going to the end of the world party tonight?
It will be if I go, man. People here push me into lockers, not dance floors.
Go to the party!
That's exactly why you should go to that party. We have to stand up to these Blackwell bullies for
Kate. Yeah, man.
You won't be alone, Daniel.
Not with you to back me up, Max. Oh, damn it. I will go to the party like it is the end of the world. Okay, maybe I won't go, but... No, I won't do that, but I'll go.
Let's talk later. Okay, Daniel? Good. Nathan is not around. I should go back to Chloe.
Oh, no. Yeah, so we got the information out of him that we wanted. So if we have a chat to Zach.
Enjoy the big game, Zachary. I hope it's not the last.
Photo.
One photo for posterity.
That's so ironic that Warren asked Max to the drive-in.
Hey, Brooke. How are you?
I'm here as usual. By the way, thanks for helping Kate down. Are you okay?
Oh. Whales.
I can't get my limited brain around that eclipse and the beached whales. I was hoping the science department had some ideas.
Warren and I are supposed to compare notes and theories this weekend.
Oh, shit.
Oh, he asked you?
You know, science geeks stick together. But honestly, neither of us can explain this phenomenon. It's pretty scary.
Drone.
I might feel better taking your drone for a quick flight.
Miss Grant finally gave up and let me fly her again. But you're going to the drive-in with Warren, so you don't have time to fly my drone.
Really? I can't fly your drone because I'm going to see ape movies with Warren?
You are perceptive, Max. Now, excuse me. My drone needs you. That's so ironic that Warren asked... So ironic that Warren...
Hey, Brooke. How are you?
I'm here as usual.
I need to find Nathan. Have you seen him around?
Ask Warren. I mean, you're going to the movies with him and everything.
Come on, Brooke. Don't be that way. So ironic that Warren asked Nathan was suspended, but...
She's talking in the background.
Warren's not good enough for you? Okay. I saw Nathan pissed and walking off campus earlier. It's not like I don't own all the original apes phones.
I have to go. Talk later, Brooke.
Okay, so...
I had to clear away another batch of dead birds. How are you doing, Max? Been a tough week.
Yeah, I know.
I know.
Yes, it has, Samuel.
Here we
How
go.
How are you?
Sad and confused, like everybody else in Arcadia Bay. You look like you have a lot of questions, too.
People.
More questions than answers.
Samuel is always here to talk.
Kate.
I actually just talked to Kate Marsh in the hospital. She's doing so much better.
Because of you, Max. That was quite a rescue.
It could have gone either way. Samuel, do you think that we each have a destiny?
Yes, I do, Max.
In many different lifetimes,
of course. Kate Marsh believed in something different, so... That's her destiny.
I believe you.
Kate just needed some more helpful spirits like her friend Max. I hope she finds them now.
David.
Do you ever talk with David Madsen?
He talks to me. I listen.
That's how David operates.
He sees things, not people. But I think he sees you, Max.
Why?
Why do you say that?
Because you both see with cameras.
I think you have better vision than both of us.
No, Max. I just look at everything from... A different angle.
Yeah, creepy angle.
Have you seen Nathan Prescott around?
That would be hard since he was suspended.
You don't sound sad, Samuel.
Nathan hurts people. The end.
What do you really know about him?
Damn.
Not enough to help you, Max. I truly wish I could. I see what you're doing.
Animals.
I definitely have questions about what's happening to the animals in Arcadia Bay.
Oh, many do. These poor creatures have no choice in what happens to them.
Beached whales.
How can anybody explain all those poor beached whales?
My dad was a fisherman, and he'd take me out to hear the whales sing. Now they just cry.
They're not alone these days. I feel so powerless.
Oh, no. You're the opposite of powerless, Max.
You think so, Samuel?
You and Arcadia Bay are connected by time and tide. So, next time I have a question, I'm coming to you.
Squirrels!
Well, I'm glad to see your squirrels are still healthy and happy on the campus.
Yeah,
me too.
Squirrels.
If something happened to them... Oh...
Not as long as you're here to take care of them, Samuel.
The only thing that calms them is food. Lots of food. Which reminds me that I have to feed them now. Today. Sad.
Makes me mad.
How would you like a partner for a quick photo op?
I think everything is changing here.
As a scientist, I'm fascinated. As Michelle Grant, I'm very worried.
Get that food in your belly.
You're scared too. Look at the weather and the animals.
Not to mention poor Kate Marsh.
We all need to look out for each other these days.
Yeah, they're hanging out. Yeah, Skrills. Yes, squirrels.
Hello, Max.
Hey, what
Hi,
up?
Ms. Grant.
Max, you always show up when I'm talking about you. I'm still bragging about you and the other students making Blackwell surveillance free.
Recent events.
I was hoping you could explain some of these crazy things happening in Arcadia Bay.
If I could, I'd be collecting my Nobel Prize in Science today. I haven't been able to wrap my mind around that eclipse, much less the snow in Wales.
Scientific
there
explanation.
There must be a scientific explanation, right?
When my friends at NASA tell me they can't explain a solar eclipse without a single theory as to how or why, maybe it's time to get worried, like they are.
I am worried about reality. I feel like it's changing right in front of us.
You and Samuel both. We were talking about that before you came over. Our planet is changing, but it's not
mystic.
It's erosion.
So, you don't think this could be some kind of prophecy or something?
Max, you know how fascinated I am by Arcadia Bay legends. But I haven't found any apocalyptic signs yet. Unless you count those end-of-the-world posters. Unless you know something I don't.
What about wormholes and chaos theory? They're like time travel stuff.
The only wormholes in Arcadia Bay are underground. And chaos theory is just that. But if this is about time travel, sign me up.
Would you really change time?
Not after reading that Bradbury story. A sound of thunder. I won't give it away, but it involves dinosaurs and butterflies. Time is like a thread, Max. One tug and it all can unravel.
Yep. Interesting.
I don't think surveillance would have helped Kate Marsh.
Who needs surveillance when we have Maxine Caulfield? You did a wonderful thing, and now we have to make sure Kate gets the help she needs. Do you need to talk to a counselor?
Blackwell needs help.
Blackwell Academy needs the help. There's something terrible going on here. You see it, right?
This week hasn't been Blackwell's finest hour. But me and some faculty members won't rest until all the students here feel safe, not bullied.
Kate was drugged at the Vortex Club party and bullied by them until she ended up on the roof. How do you stop that?
Shut down that damn Vortex Club for a start. I don't mean to get riled up, but that party should have been postponed. It's extremely tasteless given what happened with Kate.
Do the Prescotts have anything to do with the Vortex Club? I mean, they don't get all their money from car washes.
No, they don't. But membership has its privileges. Especially when your father is Blackwell's biggest sponsor. This elitist nonsense has no place here.
You're right. I just wish this could be the school that I dreamed about before I came here.
I hear you, Max.
Cool, cool.
I love seeing you and Warren and all my students at your best here. But you're all too young to be so cynical. But you truly give me hope.
Nathan.
I was looking for Nathan Prescott, and I thought he might be in your class.
Mr. Prescott has no class at all after his suspension.
I didn't think you were friends.
You probably know him better.
I've tried. Nathan is a Prescott, and with that comes a lot of baggage. Too much for one teenager. This week was the proof. Principal Wells did the right thing.
I know. Nathan needs real help.
That drone's still flying around. Let's get that drone down. down with the drone.
I didn't appreciate my help. I did see Nathan leaving the campus looking angrier than
so
you.
So everyone's saying that, yeah, he's left.
Maybe it's good you haven't found him.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant. I have to get going. I'll see you later.
It's always good talking to you, Max.
Time to go clean up graffiti. Hello, Max. For those kids.
Thanks again for helping me fight the power.
I wonder if I can get back in here. Nope, he's locking it now. Okay. See you later, squirrels.
Coast is clear. It would be so cool if you and me were going to school here together.
But now you can have Mr. Jefferson all to yourself.
Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell Ninja mode.
Ninja! How many kids going to that school? It's like bugger all.
It's so lame they don't have co-ed dorms here.
Yes, because I want Nathan Prescott in the room next door.
Good point.
Wait here. Give me the signal if Nathan or anybody shows up.
I won't let you down, Batmax.
Now I just have to find Nathan's room.
There it is. 111. Please give a promise, Gus. Okay, so 111.
Oh, Kate brings it. So, room.
Oh, why, hello, Trevor. And Dana.
Oh, jerks. At least nobody messed with the Kate portrait. Even after Kate, nobody here learned anything about bullying. Are toilet paper wars mandatory in the dorms?
111. 107. Bigfoot's got big balls.
Zach or Logan. Who knows? Bro's got a bro.
Let's have a look. Nathan's room. It's all good in the woods.
Ugh, skunk weed and video games. I sense Hayden is near. Hello, Warren's room.
There's no unique picture reality.
Poor Warren. This is the work of Nathan. He's so lucky I'm a pacifist. Looks like one of the jocks did care about Kate.
Damn.
This can only be Nathan's room.
Enter. Enter, enter, enter. Mm-hmm. Holy crap. Okay.
Now I need to find... I don't think one book can guide the Prescotts.
Max, no, Dev's not here. I need Chloe to step. So acting out so much. What would happen if you were getting mixed up in legal crap like breaking a black belt? Not. What would happen? So I need Bill the Defender to explain. I hope you would get back on the right track. It looks like she's getting stuck again. Can't be such... You could be such a good influencer unless you both want to play bad. She can't keep blaming David now. Sorry, Joyce, the shenanigans. I'm trying to be a good influencer. Chloe, I know I speak for these teenage adults.
Okay, there's definite. That is so Chloe.
Now, so we need to talk. I'm going to tell everybody what you did, and you're going to pay.
Oh my god. Chloe. Oh, Chloe. Nathan clearly has his fetish down. That must be the lamp Chloe broke when Nathan drugged her. that looks like a totally fun show.
He's still a creep. I don't care what anyone said, he's still a creep.
Damn, Nathan. That's a nice shot. If only all your energy went into photography. It's so damn creepy, but the guy has his own style. Nathan likes his tortured subjects way too much. These films all have a dark pattern. Oh man, that dickhead stole one of my selfies.
What the fuck?
Holy shit, that's the gun Nathan used on Chloe. A gift from... I don't think this prescription has helped, Nathan.
Nope. Definitely not.
That's so cute and ironic. I can't believe Nathan still has it around. That monochrome camera is brand new and costs about $6,000. Bastard. I thought Victoria had the photo bling, but once again, the Prescott's rule. I'd cry too if I had him for a father and had to wear that suit.
Use.
Nathan is way into this party. Bad sign.
I'm psyched we're going to pick us. I don't try to keep picks away from. We're going to have something. Point, right?
Bastard. Now I remember why I hate you. And why Kate will get justice. Oh, man. Sean Prescott might be Nathan's real problem.
Your mother and I are talking to me. Tell me your mother wants Dr. Bill to come out. I've just booked two of the last two prescriptions, aren't you? You're calm and cool. I need you to come and call. A penis has been developed. Prescott's better than a garage in this room. Well, it was half a minute. Dad opened his eyes and destiny. Don't remember back all the short towns going on animal.
Too bad Nathan isn't more like his sister. She sounds awesome. And far away.
Yes, well, tell me you're in trouble, father. It's been on your ass. You have to either ignore him or send him to him. Oh, I love Dad. Nathan was drunk off across the world because of him. He's a bully who had a paradigm of wisdom, though, and the only way to win against one is to fight back to let him change you. And just want the family legacy, end of lecture, you're at school. Just wanted to make you feel at home, back to the mangrove, sending your good thoughts right back. I've Jaguar shipped to your dorm.
Yes, Nathan sure needs diet pills. This is strong stuff. Wow. Kiss ass much, Principal Wells.
And then back off.
Come on. Nathan Prescott. All-American teen. Please, please, please stay away, Nathan.
Poster. Lens. Examine.
What the hell are all those marks on the floor?
Move the couch, man.
Let's find out what you're hiding.
Shit, hey?
Oh yes,
oh,
little phone.
Man.
You are mine now. Now I have Nathan's phone, so I can show it to Chloe. Well, before Nathan comes back.
Damn, Max,
here we go.
Back.
Here we go.
I got worried.
We got him. We got him.
So
we got him.
What did you find?
His room was clean and
creepy.
Check this out.
Boom, Nathan. We got you
by the balls, motherfucker.
What are you doing in my dorm? You're such a nosy bitch, Max.
Stop right there, Nathan.
Make me ho. Max, I got this. Get the fuck out of my face. You are so fucking dead! Get off me, bro!
Corin, stop it! Come on!
Oh, my head! Why y'all looking at me like that, huh? You and you, you're all dead!
Let's go, now!
Plus, my dad is on his way. You're all fucked. He owns you.
Damn. Daddy dearest.
If Nathan definitely deserved a beating, we should try to be better than that. Damn. That was intense. Warren, thank you so much.
For what?
For headbutting Nathan Prescott. That was awesome.
I don't know. I almost went crazy there. Like Nathan.
You're not anything like him.
Good to know. So where are you going? I better stick with you guys. Just in case you need me to get my Hulk on again. Or should I call the cops on Nathan?
No police. Not yet.
So maybe you better...
Warren, me and Max have to do this on our own. No offense.
It's cool. Whatever I can do to help.
What you can do is find out anything you can about Nathan's father.
Yeah, man.
I'm on it. Between the snow and eclipse, I'm assuming the apocalypse is around the corner.
True that.
Thank you.
True
Seriously.
That.
I'll call you later.
You better. I'm feeling pretty alpha now.
Yes. You are.
Man, that guy is so fucking in love with you.
I know.
He really did give a serious beatdown to Nathan.
It was a little scary to watch him do that.
Now let's make a date with Frank.
Will he even answer you?
Frank always answers when he wants money.
Okay.
Like I said, Frank wants to see me right now.
Let's not keep him waiting.
Damn. Damn you, Frank. I'm gonna see Frankos. Frankos the Tankos.
I hate seeing those poor whales like that.
Me too. I just think of
there's a low face to go.
They're looking for them. Well, that asshole is gonna help us find Rachel.
Or what? You'll actually shoot him? Chloe, do not count on my rewind. Seriously.
Obviously, I'm not counting on you. That's why I have a gun. And I might even save you someday.
About time.
I am so going to hate you. There's no way we could have guessed this is what would happen to us when we grew up.
I'm looking forward to the day when we can just go on a road trip to Portland.
Fuck yeah. You, me, and Rachel.
Absolutely. So let's play this cool, okay? Just talk to Frank so we can get that code for the book from him. That's all.
Got it. No dicking around.
Let's roll.
What the hell? All right, here we go. Here we go, here we go.
The forest seemed quiet. No sign of life. Or deer. Frank doesn't need tinted windows when they're this dirty. Aw, poor little beach ball. No worries, sign.
Damn. Okay. Oh, poor whale.
How can all of this not be connected to a major storm?
Because all of her wanting, rewinding.
This is where my nightmare started.
Oh, shit.
It blows my mind that I was just here with Chloe in an alternate reality. Good thing there are no actual cops around to bust us.
True that. Jumping on the ground, can I look at these bike racks? Okay. Okay. So let's go. Nope.
Can't see inside with this shit blocking the view.
Garbage.
Take the trash out sometime, dude. This is where Frank ponders his existence and gets drunk. Oh, fresh meat. So Pompidou must be okay. Good doggy.
Can't see anything up front. Nope, okay. Speak. Let's see what we've got. Come on, Francis.
Oh, look.
The Wonder Twins. The Wonder Twins.
You should have come alone.
She's my partner.
Yeah, we're bodyguard. So let's get to business. Where's my fucking money?
I don't have the money. Yet.
Oh, really? Then why did you text me that you did?
Because I wanted to tell you in person.
Oh, I'm truly touched, Chloe. Now, why are you losers really here?
We just want to ask you some questions.
You have some serious lady balls. No. Jesus, okay. Okay. But I'm not getting you high.
Frank, we're not here to get high.
No, you don't look like the type. Not like Chloe. So what do you hardy boys want?
Just the names of some of your clients.
Oh, is that all? Oh, well, why didn't you just tell me? How about I just give you the keys to my RV while I'm at it?
Listen, Frank. I'm sorry to be such a nuisance, but this is important.
Yeah, yeah, everything's important these days. But I can tell you're not bullshitting me.
There's no time for that, Frank. I just need a little bit of information.
Yeah, yeah, well, it always starts with just a little. And Chloe here knows all about that, don't you?
Come on, Frank, this isn't about me now.
Yeah, right, okay. Both of you are giving me a headache. No deal.
Frank, we didn't come here to fight. This is so much bigger than us.
What, you come in peace? After you aimed a fucking gun at me and then pulled the trigger.
That was our old hideout. You shouldn't have hassled us there.
Old hideout? What are you, the Goonies? I could still fuck you up after what you did. Stay out of my business. Get it?
I didn't know what I was doing.
Dude, get off her ass. She was protecting me. You've got a knife and God knows what else. Are you really afraid of Max here?
I'm not afraid of anybody except my maker. And you little bitches think you can outsmart me? Why, because I'm trailer trash? You're Blackwell trash, and it's time to take you out.
Calm down, Frank. Let's just talk.
Don't you ever tell me what to do. Get it, bitch? Get it?
Step the fuck back now!
Pompidou! You fucking killed my dog!
Oh my god!
Rewind. No, we didn't want that. We wanted.
Oh no, Chloe.
Rewind.
I just shot a man and his dog. I killed Frank Bowers.
You saved my life, Chloe. It was self-defense for both of us.
No.
Max?
We're going back.
Frank is really dead.
We are going back.
But we can't stop now. We have to find that code. Fast.
Before the cops come.
That's it. Let's get out of here.
Sorry, Frank. I'm sorry.
Listen, Chloe. I can tell you for a fact that this will not go well.
Max, I should have known you would be kind and rewind. So tell me exactly what I need to do here.
Watch your mouth.
You have no social skills here, and you will piss off Frank immediately.
You kind of love this, don't you? Fine, I'll try being like you for a change. Or how you used to be. I don't know.
Frank, your dog is kind of scary. Could you please close the RV door?
You aim your gun at me, but you're scared of my dog? That figures. Okay, there, you're safe. Now, what do you want?
Just the names of some.
Oh, is that all?
You don't get it, man. This is for a good cause.
No, man, I do not get it. Especially from a weirdo like you. You know, I hate the way you talk to me, like you know more than I do.
No, I'm not.
Christ, I hate you, Blackwell shits. You expect everything for free. You're not getting any handouts from me. I work for a living, you understand?
Yes, Frank. Without those Blackwell shits as customers, you wouldn't have any work at all. Dude, you're a drug dealer.
You snobby whores. Don't come into my home and judge me. That's why I go to church. And you want something from me? How about a blade up the ass, huh?
Calm down, Frank. Let's just
Don't
talk.
Don't you ever tell me what to do. Get it, bitch? Get it?
Step the fuck back now! Oh my god!
Gosh! You actually shot me! I wasn't gonna hurt you! Oh, this fucking hurts! Oh, it hurts!
Chloe! You shot him!
I know!
You're both fucking crazy! What do you want?
We just want the code for your account book.
Now!
You're fine! Whatever! Just put the goddamn gun down! You already shot me, alright? There. Now leave me alone, alright? Just get out of my life.
Do you want us to call an ambulance, or...?
No, thanks. You know what? I'll manage somehow without the police.
Oh, right.
Let's bounce.
Shit. This could have gone way worse, but... Frank might be more dangerous to Chloe.
I think we're gonna go.
You can change all this if you want.
I think we're gonna go down the road of.
Listen, Chloe.
Max, I should have...
You won't like this.
But you need to get rid of that gun.
You need to get rid of that gun.
No, Max, I don't like that at all. But I trust you. And girl, if I need that gun, you better rewind fast.
Thanks for hearing me out, Frank. Look, we only want to talk, and it's not even about you. We're not here to start a fight.
No, that shit would be over pretty fast. Don't fuck with me, and I won't return the favor. So what do you want?
Just the names of...
Oh, is that all?
You already did.
Ah, you fucking mental. I lost my keys, but I changed the lock. You better goddamn not be snooping around here.
No, no, I'm...
Oh, Christ, I hate...
Yes, Frank, without those bl...
Calm down, Frank. Let's just talk.
Don't you ever tell me what to do. Get it, bitch? Get it? How do you like my play, kid? Huh?
Whoa! Chloe!
Get off of me!
Motherfucker!
So close the door. Close the door, no weapons. Speak. Get rid of your gun.
You won't like
no.
You ain't. Hey, there.
Just.
Oh.
Help us. Or else.
Are you actually threatening me again, little girl?
No, no, I'm not.
Oh, Christ.
Yes, Frank, without those black.
Calm down, Frank. Let's just talk.
Don't you ever tell me what to do. Get it, bitch? Get it? How do you like my play, kid? Huh?
Whoa! Chloe!
Get off of me!
Motherfucker!
You're both fucking crazy! What do you want?
We just want the code for your account book.
There. Now leave me alone, alright? Just get out of my life.
Probably the better option.
No, thanks. You know what? I'll manage somehow without the police.
It's probably the better of all three.
Right. Let's bounce.
Doesn't have the knife in there anymore, though. On the leg. Yeah, I think it's probably the better idea. Out of all of them. Alright, let's leave the beach. Let's see where else we gotta go. Right. Starting to decipher what is going on.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sorry, I just keep thinking about Frank.
Please don't. You saved us. Frank is lucky. We have to keep moving forward.
Right.
I better focus on this board and start. Thanks to David's own investigation, I should be able to find out what Nathan did during the party. I hope in this case that David has good tracking skills. You need to get rid of these damn cameras, David.
Okay, so... Nathan's clues?
I have to analyze Nathan's messages. What could help me unlock this phone?
Oh, right here.
Holy shit. Nathan is seriously unhinged. But those numbers might be useful. This is the Vortex Club party where Nathan drugged Kate. Did he do the same thing to Rachel at another party? If there is a dark room, we better find it. It's a good thing Chloe slipped all these files on her flash drive.
Right. So if we go select this one here, look at it.
So busted. It's good to see the press.
So what is intro to literature class? Right. One out of 4.
Let's look at Frank's drug deals during the week of the party. Frank's account book. But the client names are encrypted. No. This is not working. I have to analyze Nathan's messages.
Right, so we go there.
What could help me unlock this phone? We go there.
We go... Look here.
There's a lot of numbers in here.
Go there, and we could go
there. Okay, Max, let's blow this code up and go home. Let's start hacking.
Nine, 5, 3, 5.
Oops, bad code.
Okay.
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy. You locked it, dumbass.
Double 0 5 8.
Oops, bad code.
Four.
code.
Four, four, three, six.
Oops, bad code. Let's start hacking.
Five, 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 0198 and 0763.
Bad code.
Let's go to Frank's clues.
Frank is for sure the local dealer, but I doubt Rachel was carrying drugs for him. Right? Rot must stand for Rottweiler. That does fit Nathan. Rotten. There's no doubt she loved him in some way. Yes, the game is on. Now, talk to us, account book. Tell us everything. Let's see if I can find... Okay, Max, remember these names and see how Nathan fits in with all this. Frank sure is keeping his customers satisfied. He could open a store.
Look. So rot. Fun places that have rot written on it.
Two deals with Nathan on the same day? Party supplies, no doubt. Everybody in Arcadia Bay must be high. That explains a lot. I'm getting a contact high just reading this. If Frank applied this kind of detail to his life, who am I to talk? I wonder what dog name Frank would have given me. These are all the times and places for Frank and Nathan's deals. That's it, Max. David should have done way more than take photos of Kate. And that's all she wrote. please let me find some clues about Nathan in here.
Max, I know we can snap all these pieces together.
Right. Great. Now, how do I find out which car is Nathan's to match the coordinates? Of course Nathan drives an SUV. Overcompensating, as usual. Who does this car belong to? Interesting. Is this Nathan's car?
Nope, so...
Yep, another car David was tracking.
Okay.
Who else was David tracking here? Oh yes, now we're finally getting somewhere.
Chloe. Let's plug in these numbers and see if they lead to an actual address.
Aye, aye, Captain. Here we come, Rachel.
Let me unlock his phone. Okay.
Oops, bad code.
If you look at this, we'll phone number 555-0198. Okay, so 9535443654431.
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy.
398.
You locked it, dumbass.
8789 7808 8797. So 8789 8789 7808.
Let's find out what Nathan Prescott has been trying to hide.
Okay.
Yes. This is all about Nathan trying to score for the Vortex Club party. Nathan was jonesing hard the night of the party. He didn't have enough drugs. Drug dealer drama. God, Nathan. You're out of control. So it was you. Now I can officially call you a psycho stalker. No, Nathan. It's time for you to watch out. Asshole. Is this from Nathan's father? That's brutal.
Cool.
Take a breath, Max. Go through all this data and you can find out where Nathan took Kate after the party. So, this infamous party was the fourth.
So now we look at the fourth. It's the seventh. It's the seventh. To 10:26. 10:26. Ten thirty-four on the fourth. 10:34.
Was Frank meeting Nathan at the junkyard?
Boondocks.
That beach is like Frank's main office. I know Nathan wasn't looking for Bigfoot in the forest. Somebody is stocking up on gas. Why? No doubt that Nathan stays in his dorm room. So, he could be hiding clues there too. Not much out there. Oh, that has to be the Prescott estate. Poor rich Nathan. Chloe. This is definitely the place.
Let me
this a bit of sleuth in there, man. Figured it out.
Nope. Nothing, Max. There's nothing here. Just a shitty old barn.
Let's keep searching and find out who owns this haunted barn.
I'm on this. Hold on.
Prescott's no doubt.
Somebody named Harry Aaron Prescott.
I'm shocked. Should we call the police?
Fuck that. You know the police here are like Nathan's private security, right?
True that.
That's so messed up.
As you know, this whole town is messed up. We can't trust anybody except each other. True. So we have to go out to that farmhouse by ourselves.
I was afraid you'd say that.
Damn.
We could call Warren since he kicked Nathan's ass.
It's just the two of us, nobody else. And I'm not scared at all. You have the power. I feel like we're this close to finding Rachel. We have to find her, Max.
We will. But remember, my power isn't infinite. We still have to be careful. Do you hear, Chloe?
Yes, sir.
Hopefully we get closer to Rachel. This is gonna be cool. This is gonna be hella cool. Spooky barn. Spooky barn is very spooky.
Holy shit, this is scary.
Yeah, man.
But we're here. Let's go find the best way in.
Ooh.
Whoa, check this out. Fresh tire tracks.
Dude, somebody was just here.
Then we need to get in that barn.
Okay, so I guess you're looking for stuff. Yep.
These are thick tracks and definitely fresh. Nathan's SUV? Watch us.
Someone's got a very similar handwriting.
Watson, we can safely assume that this ancient vehicle is not our suspect.
Bullshit.
Let's have a look around. Okay. There's nothing here. There's nothing here. Metal sheets. Shit, eh?
Chloe, I found the front door. Come on.
Oh, yes. Maximus rules.
This is way too Blair Witch. I have goosebumps.
It's getting spoopy.
Hey, check out this old chest.
Something in there, man.
A little louder, Chloe. Jeez, that is ancient.
Jackpot. Old shit.
No, look closer.
Harry, Aaron, Prescott, and family donate new library to Arcadia Bay. Prescott Industries celebrate grand opening. The Prescotts bring bomb shelter boom to town.
Nice scrapbook. You search for more clues and I'll scope out the area.
Okay.
Yes, old Prescott clippings. Even Harry Aaron Prescott was into
stuff. Tractor.
This tractor has paid its dues.
There are those tracks again.
Okay, there's no reason for anybody to drive out here. But there must be. I guess the Prescotts were just born bastards.
They're not saying death shows they ignore Prescott's not be established management. Gentlemen, be take a silence personal insult the state of family name and making you pay your debt 10% interest. Apology if these conditions are met by the end of the day. Maybe living hell. Okay. There's a door there.
So many haystacks, so few needles.
I know there's a door there, I just want to look at all this shit.
The good old days.
Old. Old.
If a zombie shows up, I have them.
Oh, lordy. So there is a door here. Hey?
Nothing here.
Scope out the perimeter, Max. There has to be more here than this crate.
Just rotting wood.
It's probably just a thing.
Nothing here.
No more secrets, Sean Prescott.
There's no way this rusty-ass button will activate these ropes or pulleys. Wow, sir. Talk about home on the range.
There has to be another floor.
Scope out the perimeter, Max. There has to be more here than this crate.
Hey? Something here.
Whoa.
Shit.
What is this? It's totally brand new. Why? Ah, the good old days. So many haystacks, so few needles.
There has to be a key here somewhere. There has to be a key.
If a zombie shows up, I have
nope. Let's see what's over here, maybe. Crate, haystack. Let's open this padlock.
No, Supermax. You can't open this with your bare hands.
So that's...
Okay, Chloe. I found some kind of hatch, but it's locked. I got this. I hope.
Let me know the second you need any help. Old.
Ah, wouldn't be an idiot. The rope leads up to that platform. Must climb.
Chloe, can you give me a hand?
Okay.
Sidekick at your service.
Okay.
Hop, hop, and away, Supermax.
I dig having minions.
Let's have a look and see what we've got. Up here. Climb up here.
Please be careful up there, Max.
There's a barn owl, but there isn't really much more than that. Okay.
Here's the other end of the rope.
So So, yeah.
Hey, Chloe, can you attach the hook to that padlock?
Oh, you are clever. I am all over this. I will be done.
Then you better step away from that hatch. Nope. I can't pull this rope without tearing my flesh off. I need to hook this up to something heavier.
Mm-hmm.
Max, use your rewind and get that motor back up there.
Mm-hmm. Hook, attach it to the thing. Yep. Do I have to take a photo of that barn owl? He's already gone. He's already gone. Okay. Attach it. Okay.
Do not fall.
MacGyver strikes again.
Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Alright.
Damn, this is heavy.
Oh, shit.
What is this?
Shit. Wow.
Do I even need to say how bad this is?
He just did. Who built this kind of place?
A Prescott, of course.
Okay, so this is where it's gonna get kinda weird, because this dude's into some like weird shit, I'm guessing. Right? Like, I just, here we go. Here we go.
This bunker is so surreal.
Five, four, two.
Oh, yes! I thought that only worked in movies.
They did well. They did well with that,
Open sesame.
Oh, that's so bad. It was hella spoopy. Oh,
Shocked and ready for the apocalypse. This must have cost a fortune. Come on.
Shit. Cans, water.
What the hell is? Look at these cans. David must shop at the same store. More survivalist supplies.
Weird shit.
Water supplies. It's like in David's garage bunker. duct tape in a bunker is always a bad sign.
Jesus, I already hate this place.
Whoa. This says it all about Nathan. He needs help.
What the fuck?
I guess Nathan needs the most expensive printer in the world.
What the fuck, man?
Son of a bitch.
$1.3 million. Oh man, he's the one with the files. Oh shit. No way.
Come on. Let's see what this shit is all about.
We are. Okay. A binder marked Victoria, but it's empty.
Look, the next one says Kate.
Oh no, Kate. No.
God, I should have killed that bastard back there.
Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims. Victoria has to be next. Nathan must be planning to dose her tonight at the Vortex Club.
Oh no.
Rachel.
Oh no.
This can't be real. These are all post shots, right? Right?
Chloe, look at her face. She's out of it.
Maybe Nathan paid her a shitload of cash to do this. She probably would have.
I don't think so. Why is he putting her in the ground like that? Where?
The junkyard. Max, we have to find that spot now. Then we can see what he did. There's no way she's dead. No way. She posed for those pictures, Max. I know it. Please. Let's go.
Shit.
Oh my god. Rachel. Kate. Oh yeah, school suspension is a deal breaker in the Prescott family. Shit. That's Nathan's jacket. Has he been here recently?
What the fuck?
These newspapers are all about Rachel and Kate.
What the fuck, man?
Somebody likes their whiskey. Needles. Gross. This must be the crap that Nathan gets from Frank.
Tripod.
So who's using this fancy tripod?
This is fucked up. This is fucked up.
I've never seen so much pricey equipment before. That's an original signed illustration. Fits perfect in here. Talk about tortured.
What the fuck?
Let's see what's in here. Oh my god. No.
This Nathan guy's fucked up, man. Get the fuck out of here, man. Let's place to the ground. That's fucked. So Nathan's fucked up. He's a fucked up kid, man. He is a fucked up kid. I don't care what anyone says. That's messed up. Oh shit, they're gonna find Rachel.
Look, this is it.
Stop! Look. Please, no.
That smell.
Rachel. Oh, Rachel, no, no, please not her.
It's fucked.
I loved her so much. How can she be dead? What kind of world does this? Who does this?
Fucking Prescott kid. That's fucked, man. What the hell? A deer. Is that? Oh man, I got goosebumps. That's messed up. That is completely messed up. What the hell? So now we go to this party. You know where the missing girl is. Why don't you just connect all the dots, like, right now? Oh, Jesus.
I hope Nathan enjoys his last party.
Chloe, we can go right to the cops. We have proof.
Fuck the police. Rachel wanted us to find her. So we could get real justice. And revenge. The Prescotts have had this coming for 100 years, and nobody is gonna get in my way. Especially with your help. Right?
He's gonna get it.
To the end, Chloe.
He's...
You know that.
Bring out peace. Bring out the big peace. Just Nathan's gonna get it.
You're right. Look at the outline.
I can't tell if they're different.
What is that?
There can't be two moons.
Jesus, Chloe, look up at the sky.
Beautiful. I don't give a shit. The world is ending. Cool.
You're not listening. Something major is going down.
That's right. Nathan Prescott is going down.
Two moons? Hey?
Welcome to the end of the world, ladies. I'm glad you decided to escort me.
You look really good, Warren. Are you alright after today?
I'm glad you stopped me. Nathan is dangerous.
Where is he?
I didn't see him at the dorm again. I was held up in my room.
Dude, have you been drinking?
Well, if you consider half a beer drinking.
Let's go, Max.
Hey, hey. I know this is a bad time, but can I get one picture? I've been feeling like this might be actually the end of the world, so I want to have something for prosperity.
Well, I don't blame you.
Oh, this kid.
I know, I'm a pain in the booty. Just one picture.
Action.
Jeez.
We've got no time for this shit. Come on, Max.
Sorry. I just wanted to feel like a normal student after this week's ultra violence. I never hit anybody like that before. I was always the one getting my ass kicked.
Wow. Hey.
We still need your expert help. If you see
I still can't get over Nathan's crap. Okay?
And do not let him see you.
He won't. I know how to be invisible here.
Not to me, Warren. Text soon.
Preppy prep schools that are preppy. It's pretty good. Here we go. Hi, can I take your code or
anything? No, I didn't see any tablet with cat pics.
Okay, Chloe, where the hell are you?
I hate touching all these clothes.
It is kind of nasty.
Hi, Stella. Hey, Max. Welcome to the end of the world. Do you want me to check anything in?
No thanks, Stella.
Have Ooh, you here seen we go. Ethan yet?
No, thank God.
Here we go.
That boy creeps me out. Wait, some girl just asked about Nathan before you came in.
What girl?
She had blue hair, dressed like a punk. I've seen her putting up those Rachel Amber posters. I'm stuck here, so I'm sorry I can't help
you. So why are you working at a Vortex Club party? I didn't think you wanted to be a
member. Screw yeah, true that. I'm here for the job.
Who hired you?
Mr. Jefferson asked me because he knows I don't have a lot of money, even with my job and scholarship. I'm not cool enough for this school.
Yes, you are, Stella. You're smart, honest, and you bust your ass.
Ooh, here we go.
I hope everything turns out your way in the end.
Yep.
Thank you, Max.
Yep.
I really appreciate that. Hey, your face looks so intense. Are you okay?
No, I'm actually not okay. I just need to find Nathan. And don't get too close if you see him.
Hell no. This is homework, not a party. I'll text you if I spy him. Good luck.
Oh, is that chick over here? Nope. Don't know any of them. Don't know her. Let's get in the Vortex Club party. Okay. Crap.
We need to find Nathan and take him down.
Party.
I didn't expect that either, but I really need to find Nathan. Have you?
No, I haven't seen him. And I'm not looking for him, so I most likely won't tonight. I just hate that scrub and his club.
You're not the only one. Maybe this party will be the end of the Vortex.
Then I don't have to pretend like I care anymore.
Damn.
Have you seen Warren tonight?
No, I was talking to Dan. He asked me to go with him to the Portland Art Museum this weekend.
Ooh! They're finally hooking up.
I bet Dan would be a great museum guy.
I'm more into science than art, but what kind of a selfish fangirl would miss a Miyazaki exhibition?
You're not selfish, bro. You're just trying to live your life without all this bullshit. Like all of us here.
You seem so wise. Kind of invincible this week. I think that snow and eclipse gave you superpowers. Check to see if you can fly.
Only with your drone.
That's insane.
Did you see that crazy double moon out there earlier?
Max, if I saw a double moon out there, I would assume it really was the end of the world.
Well, the night is still young.
And so are we, Max. So let's plan a drone date next week.
Mending friendships, yes. Mending
Let's
friendships.
I only came to the party because of you.
I'm glad to see you out and about.
Oh, Loth, what's up, bro?
By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott tonight?
No, I've been hanging with Brooke since I got here.
Ooh.
Max, are you okay? Your face looks so
serious.
I know. I'm not in party mode tonight.
Look like you're on a secret mission.
This is where it's going to end. For Rachel's sake.
Oh, Max, you need a black whale break. I'm taking Brooke to a Miyazaki show in Portland. If you want to come along, more the merrier.
Thanks, Daniel. I have to stay on my mission now. I hope you stay on yours and become a great artist.
Good old Daniel.
Someday in a museum, Max. Adios.
Adios, Max.
No one seems to know where Nathan is.
Rony, Daniel Rony.
Is he hiding or something? Energy drinks. Energy drinks. I know somebody has those. Here's Courtney drinking alone, without Taylor or Victoria. I wonder why.
I just flew.
I almost didn't see you.
Max, you're the only person I don't mind seeing right now.
I was looking for Nathan.
I've avoided almost everybody here tonight.
What the hell?
I want to make sure he's not gonna do anything tonight.
Like what happened to Kate.
Yep.
I have dreams that somebody finally kicks his ass one day.
Sometimes dreams come true. Today I saw Warren give Nathan an epic headbutt.
Yes, give it up for brother Warren. Now all we have to do is drive all these goddamn Prescott vampires out of town.
Damn, so no one wants them. Sean Prescott Vortex Club, Sean Prescott Vortex Club, Sean Prescott Vortex Club.
That'll be hard to do when the
Prescott's on the town and Vortex Club.
And the Vortex
Ooh.
Club. I call it the Vortex Club.
Get rid of them.
Look at this crap. Dress code? VIP section?
Yeah, that's insane.
This bullshit.
Preach it, Brother Luke.
Oh, man.
Okay, I have to get going. Thanks for seeing me.
No, thank you.
Here we go.
For helping Kate. And for keeping it real. Peace
out. Alrighty, alrighty.
Bigfoot on otter action.
There's the stoners. What the hell?
You do suffer.
You know who I am? No, it's your name.
Excuse me, but I'm going in.
Sorry, but this is the VIP section. Members only. Okay?
Sorry, but I'm on the list. Okay?
I know that Max Caulfield is not on any list for the Vortex Club. Nice try.
Listen.
No, you listen. Courtney is supposed to be the VIP gatekeeper, not me. So please go.
I need to find
a way to enter this bullshit club.
Hey, Max! What are you doing in here?
Apparently, Blackwell has a severe toilet paper fetish.
I can drink more later. Yo, Maximum Overdrive, about time you got here to save this lame rave. Wanna get ripped?
You look pretty ripped already, Justin.
Shaka, brah.
Why did you even
Time to get ripped.
Where else could I go in Arcadia Bay on a Thursday night? Besides, Dana is here. She's not with me. So yes, this party sucks.
You're obviously not cool with Trevor dating Dana.
I try to front like I was. When I saw them together,
oh man, this kid
came over to cry like a
little bitch.
No, it's more like somebody who's in pain. I'm sorry, Justin, but you're a cool, considerate guy, and you're gonna find somebody just as cool, minus the drama.
Max, I know I'm twisted, but your face looks so fucking intense, and your voice sounds different. You okay? How about a quick dab?
No, I'm cool, Justin. And I have to get going. Maybe you should go chill somewhere else.
Fucking A, Maximus. You're right. I'm only torturing myself here. Plus, I'm too loaded. It's time to get my board and grind.
He is ripped.
The tide is turning. Chloe must be around. Oh, gross.
Can you
How did this even get? Good night, sweet prince.
You've been vomiting for
this
like an hour.
This is the last Vortex Club party.
Somebody's either having sex or throwing up. Or both. Ugh, Max.
Coming in, sister.
I'd like to tear every one of these things down.
Right, so... if I get, like, is there, like, some drinks or something that I can, like, tip on that kid's head? If I can go in here, then clearly there's something that can be done, right?
Not anymore.
Jesus.
I'm so not impressed by this VIP crap.
The phone.
Oh shit! Alyssa, are you okay?
Yes, I just got tagged by a water weenie and fell in the pool. I'm sorry.
Oh man. So you're not anyone? Nope. You don't look familiar. Not any people look familiar. This chick doesn't look familiar. Let's see what's going on the side pool. Oh, rip. Awesome! In the Vortex Club. VIP.
Nathan is the Vortex Club. So his... that has to be here tonight. Makes me want to pull a carry on the Vortex Club. Kate almost dead. Rachel dead. Enter the Vortex Club. Look at these entitled assholes. They don't give a shit about anybody. If that tornado came right now, I would just sit here and watch for a while.
Damn.
But I have to make sure Chloe doesn't go on her own rampage. I hate feeling this way. Dark and angry. The Vortex Club actually hired DJ Doom for the party.
You're all in my dad. I feel selfish
yes,
going to a
but
I love that Trevor doesn't care how goofy he dances in the VIP section.
Yay, Max! I can't believe you showed up. Why didn't you tell me? We could have dressed up together.
As you can tell by my outfit, I was in a hurry. Dana, have you seen Nathan around?
No, I've been dancing with Trevor. Come on and dance with us. Look at Trevor trying to bust a move.
How's the end of the world going?
Great. This has been the worst fucking week of my life, so I needed to act like a carefree student tonight. For Kate.
I hear you, Dana. But I want you to avoid Nathan if you see him, okay?
I will if I want to have fun. I still feel sorry for him. He needs help, but not from his family.
Yeah, sure that. Vortex Club.
The Vortex Club is also enabling.
I know. Juliet wrote a story describing it like a cult, and I'm starting to think she was right. It's not fun anymore.
Sounds like you're ready for a change.
Damn.
I don't need any club to be cool or have friends. Look at you. Plus, I like hanging with Trevor and his skater friends. No drama.
That sounds like a plan, Dana.
Cool.
I'm glad Trevor is with you tonight.
Thanks. The boy cannot dance, though. Look at that.
I know Victoria is next on Nathan's hit list. Should I warn her?
Yes.
Max, but if you're not going to shake
Victoria,
that
your
picture
is so
after I do.
Yeah,
love
that
ya.
Would be wicked.
I'm trying.
Yay,
I
want
her.
Oh, I guess.
As you can tell, I'm
real fucking
hell
nice.
You guys look really happy together.
Yeah.
I think we are. He's so different than Logan. We actually talk about life. And he knows how to be safe.
I hear you, Dana. But I want you to avoid Nathan.
I will if I want to have fun.
What do you know about his dad, Sean Prescott?
Rich. And rich. And a dickhead, according to Nathan.
Okay.
The Prescotts can't buy a happy family or a happy club.
Sounds like you're ready for a change.
I don't need
a cell.
Thanks.
Nope, don't know them. It's Victoria.
Sorry, Max. Vortex Club members only.
Sorry. I'm on the guest list.
I'm taking you off.
Go fuck yourself, Victoria. I don't have time for this bullshit.
Real cute, Max. And after I apologized to you the other day.
Do you even
She's
have a clue what's
a
going on at Black?
Cow.
Kate Marsh tried to kill herself in front of you. And me. Everybody here.
That's not my fault, Max. Don't you even try to blame me.
I blame Nathan for dosing Kate, but nobody at that party even cared she was so wasted.
It's a fucking party. Everybody is wasted. What do you want from me?
Some humanity, Victoria.
Well, you got Nathan busted out of Blackwell, so you should be happy. And I'm the only person here who cares what Nathan is going through.
This is bigger than a problem, child.
I'm not perfect, okay? I'm a teenager at an art school.
Yeah, but you're also an idiot.
I'm only here to become a photographer and get famous.
Is that what you were trying to tell Mr. Jefferson last night?
You saw me talking to him?
Saw and heard.
We were just talking about how excited he is for the Everyday Heroes contest. That doesn't mean I'm going to win or anything.
I hope you win fair.
We'll see. And Max, I know you don't like me either, so it's not like we have to be friends or
Jeez.
Anything.
Maybe, but who says we have to be enemies?
Whoever makes that decision.
That would be us, Victoria.
Well, Max Caulfield, I could always choose to let you in the Vortex Club.
I don't think that's gonna happen. But not for the reasons you think.
Oh, you look so serious.
Victoria,
there we go.
What
hell's up with this music? It's just like showing up.
I know,
out of nowhere. What the hell?
Really unstable and dangerous.
This music is stupid.
What? Nice try, Max. But I don't believe you. And why would he do that?
That I don't know. But it was enough to make Kate want to die. And I think you're next.
Max, that is crazy. Nathan is like one of my best friends. Yes, he takes serious meds. But that's not his fault. His family treats him like a total freak just because he has little meltdowns.
They're not little anymore. They're deadly. I don't care if you hate me or not. You have to believe me.
You could have been a major bitch to me when I got hit with that paint, and I deserved it.
Max, I don't hate you. I actually think you're one of the coolest people at Blackwell. Weird, but cool. You just don't know it yet. Maybe I'm jealous because you don't give a shit what anybody thinks, and I do. To be honest, Nathan has been freaking me out lately. He's not here, and I haven't seen him.
Just make sure you stay away from him. And stick close to your friends tonight, okay?
I let you boss me around this one time. And I have other people I can go to for protection. Thanks for telling me this, Max. If what you said is true, then you be careful.
Boom.
I've got my own protection.
Redemption.
Text me if you need anything.
I will. Thanks, Victoria.
Au revoir.
There she is, Chloe.
Maybe there's hope yet for Victoria and me. I'm glad I warned her. I hope she's okay. She's wasted and nobody is looking out for her. That son of a bitch is not here.
This guy's Super Max.
Super Max here to save the party.
Have you seen Nathan?
I just vaped some dang OG buds. I can barely see. Are these hotties next to me?
I want to find Nathan.
Me too. He's supposed to be bringing some special party favors. The party,
this guy's crazy.
So, has anybody here seen Nathan?
Hey, Colonel.
Yes, you have.
Yeah, man. I can't wait to see what's going on. Victoria.
What about Victoria?
Go ask her yourself. I would. Like I said.
Fucking rip.
Maybe you gotta take the
whatever.
Oh, man.
I'm in this world to have fun. Try it sometime, Max. I finally get you and Dana to come out to a vortex club party, but you just wanna lecture.
Oh, come on. Come on.
How much fun did Kate have at your last party? Listen to me. Just watch out for Nathan.
I think that's your job, Max. Come back when you're ready.
Silly, silly, silly.
Someone think the destiny's already fulfilled. It's all wrong, I can see it in your eyes, hit your lip and left to right. It's all wrong, gonna take it in your step, is this really for what you strive? Your head's rash, it's hard to keep quiet, fire to gas.
There you are. Chloe, Nathan isn't here. Nobody has seen you tonight.
He's definitely not upstairs or in the locker.
Damn. Maybe he's hiding in his dorm.
Then let's bail. Nathan can't hide anymore.
Hey, Mr. Jefferson.
Jesus, guy.
Are you both okay?
Who's the first one?
You look like you're on a mission.
I was just looking for Nathan.
Uh-huh. I didn't know you were pals with him. I haven't seen him since this afternoon.
Jeez, here we go.
Upset. I think he's still quite upset over the whole Kate situation.
Oh, here we go.
That makes sense.
Let's talk later, Max. I have to announce the winner of the contest. I do wish you would have entered. You have to build up that resume and portfolio, but I know you will.
Thanks. I hope so.
Okay, excuse me. I'm almost gone.
Get the hell out of here, Max.
Oh no.
Okay, everybody calm down. Thank you. I appreciate it. I don't want to get in the way of the party, but it's time to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes Contest. Before I do, I want to thank everybody who entered their photograph and everybody who thought about entering. Now, this is the most important step in being
You're
an artist.
So hot.
Sharing your work with the world. All of you represent Blackwell Academy.
I just don't know.
And everything.
I got a weird feeling about this.
As far as I'm concerned, you're all everyday heroes. The envelope, please. And the winner is...
Come on!
Oh my, what a shocker.
Victoria Chase.
Yeah. Boo her. Boo her the fuck off stage.
Thank you so much, Mr. Jefferson. It was your incredible photography that Here brought me to Blackwell, and I hope I can live up to your name and fame. I also want to thank all the students for being so dedicated in their pursuit. And Ooh. I'd like to dedicate this prize to Kate Marsh. She is the real everyday hero of Blackwell.
These nuts.
And I can't wait for her to come back.
Got it!
Thanks Got for following, Kona.
Victoria won. Big surprise. I can't believe she blackmailed Jefferson. Yes,
oh, here we go.
Who fucking cares? Rachel is still dead, and I want Nathan's punk ass now.
Me too. Let's go check out the dormitory.
Oh, fuck, this can't be good. This cannot be good. No way, this cannot be good.
Oh, Christ. Nathan just texted me.
Shit,
he says there won't be any evidence left after he's done. Shit. We have to go to the junkyard right now.
Fuck. Is that the two universes coming together? Like, it's all coming to like a resolution or something? That's kind of weirdly poetic, I guess.
Stop stomping around, Chloe.
That water, though.
Just get ready to use your rewind fast if Nathan tries to jump us.
Shit, here we go.
Okay.
Okay. Where you at? It's gonna be like some spoopy thing that's gonna jump out. I guess it's gonna be some spoopy thing that jumps out.
We have to be invisible. Max, please hurry.
Crap.
Oh God, Max, look. She's still there. Don't look, Chloe.
Fuck. No. The hell, man? Oh, this game's fucked up. This game's fucked up. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. This is the Jefferson the entire time. What the fuck? No. No, no way. Then what was Nathan's play in all this then? That is messed up, Kona. That is messed up, man. So, yeah. Refuse Chloe's request. Let Warren beat up Nathan. Stop Warren beat up Nathan. Victoria believe in warning. Chloe wounded Frank. Save the Blue Jade instead of the Bird's Nest. Your David's files in another way. Another room, Nathan's room. Danny was hurt, send the Vortex Club Party. You know, message on Warren's slate. And figure out Nathan's pin code. It didn't help Alyssa. What the hell? That is completely messed up. That was the end of Life is Strange episode 4. I'm completely speechless. What the hell? I didn't think that it was Mr. Jefferson at all. I thought Nathan, it was Nathan. I definitely didn't see.